Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss one of the new medication, Pimavanserin. Pimavanserin is one of the new medication recently approved, and this drug belongs to the category of atypical antipsychotics. This drug is particularly indicated for the treatment of Parkinson disease psychosis. This is one of the clinical conditions observed in the people with Parkinson disease who are having psychotic symptoms like hallucinations and delusions. To treat these psychotic symptoms, pimavanserin can be given. It is very interesting that Parkinson disease is a motor dysfunction, but psychosis is a mental disorder. Both are somewhat different, and Parkinson disease mainly involves few of the symptoms like slow movements, bradykinesia, jerky movements, along with some muscle stiffness and muscle rigidity, which may cause involuntary movements. So all these are the symptoms of Parkinson disease, but as the disease progresses, this Parkinson disease can also affect mood and behavior in the people. So with progression of Parkinson disease, people may have symptoms of depression and dementia, loss of memory. Along with these symptoms, in such people, we can also observe psychotic symptoms like hallucinations and delusions. In order to treat these psychotic symptoms, pimavanserin is used, and this is the only one medication among the antipsychotics that is approved for the treatment of Parkinson disease psychosis. In order to treat the Parkinson disease, we can use few of the medications, and most of the medications are going to increase the dopamine levels. As the dopaminergic transmission increases, the symptoms of Parkinson disease are reduced, resulting in the improvement in motor functions. But as the dopamine levels are elevated, it may induce psychosis in the people, resulting in hallucinations and delusions. So psychotic symptoms are one of the important group of side effects that can be produced by anti-Parkinsonian agents. And in order to treat these hallucinations, we can use the antipsychotics. But most of the antipsychotics work by reducing the dopamine actions. And as the dopamine effects are reduced, in such people, we can observe symptoms like Parkinson disease. So antipsychotics produce extra pyramidal side effects which resemble Parkinson disease. So it is very interesting that the drugs which are used for Parkinson disease can induce the psychosis, and the drugs which are used to treat psychosis can induce the symptoms of Parkinson disease. In such situation, we require a drug which is selectively reducing the hallucinations without producing any motor disturbances. So pimavanserin is such type of medication which is not showing any activity on dopamine D2 receptors. Due to lack of action on dopamine, pimavanserin is not producing any motor side effects. So this drug is not producing any Parkinson-like symptoms. Therefore, extra pyramidal side effects are very less pronounced with pimavanserin. At the same time, this drug is going to acting on serotonin receptors. Here we can observe the suffix serin within the name of this medication, which indicates it is acting on serotonin receptors. And this medication can have two effects on serotonin receptors. It can act as an antagonist, otherwise it can act as inverse agonist. Inverse agonist produce same actions like antagonist, but it can also reverse the actions of serotonin, thereby it can control hallucinations in an effective way. And third important thing is that pimavanserin is an atypical agent. So it is a second generation antipsychotic with less extrapyramidal side effects and no Parkinson-like symptoms. That's why this medication is particularly used to control hallucinations and delusions in the people with Parkinson disease. So today in this video, we are going to discuss about this pimavanserin, how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see how this drug acts. As we have discussed earlier, pimavanserin is not showing any activity on dopamine D2 receptors. Instead, it acts as antagonist on 5-HT2A receptors as well as 5-HT2C receptors. So this is the presynaptic neuron which is storing the serotonin, and this is the postsynaptic neuron which is expressed with 5-HT2A receptors. Now 5-HT can be released by calcium-mediated exocytosis. When the action potential reaches to the presynaptic neuron, calcium can enter, which can produce exocytosis, leading to release of 5-HT. This 5-HT acts on 5-HT2A receptors. which activates phospholipase C. This phospholipase C is a cleavage enzyme which can convert the phosphatidyl inositol biphosphate into two fragments. One is IP3, inositol triphosphate, and second one is DAC, diacyl glycerol. Both of these mediators can produce the excitation in the neuron, leading to hallucinations and delusions. Even this is a complex process, but the overactivation of 5-HT2A receptors may be responsible for development of hallucinations and delusions. Now, pimavanserin is one of the new medication which selectively acts on 5-HT2A receptors as an antagonist as well as inverse agonist. So it reduces the activity of 5-HT2A receptors, thereby it can reduce the psychotic symptoms. In this way, pimavanserin can be used in the people with Parkinson's disease psychosis. Now let's see the precautions of this medication. One of the important precautions of this medication is that, just like many of the antipsychotics, pimavanserin can produce prolongation of QT interval within the ECG. As the QT interval increases, it may lead to fatal cardiac arrhythmias. So this drug should be carefully given in the people who are having more risk for developing cardiac arrhythmias. Particularly, this drug should be carefully combined with other drugs like class 1A antiarrhythmic agents. For example, drugs like quinidine, procainamide are the class 1A antiarrhythmic agents which are proarrhythmic in nature. They can increase the QT interval within the ECG that may lead to fatal cardiac arrhythmias. Normally, class 1A antiarrhythmics are sodium channel blockers. So these are the various phases of action potential under normal conditions. With use of class 1A antiarrhythmic agents, this action potential is modified like this, and we can observe an increase in the action potential duration. As the action potential duration increases, plateau phase increases, which increases the entry of potassium, leading to prolongation of QT interval. So class 1A drugs can prolong the QT interval, so they should be carefully combined with pimavanserin. Similarly, few other drugs like class 3 antiarrhythmic agents like amiodarone, sotalol, they are also proarrhythmic in nature. They can also increase the QT interval. They can act in a different way. They can increase the QT interval by increasing the plateau phase. As the plateau phase increases, more potassium enters into the cardiac cells, resulting in prolongation of QT interval. So all these drugs should be carefully combined with pimavanserin in order to avoid fatal cardiac arrhythmias. Apart from these, if you have the antipsychotics like chlorpromazine, thioredazine, ziprasidone, all these drugs are having the potential to increase QT interval within the ECG. So again, these drugs should be carefully combined with pimavanserin. Similarly, if you have the antibiotics like moxifloxacin can also increase the QT interval. Care should be taken while using other medicines, particularly class 1A drugs, class 3 drugs, antipsychotics and antibiotics should be carefully combined with pimavanserin. Similarly, this drug should be carefully given in the people with any history of cardiac arrhythmias. So it is not suitable in the people with any bradycardia or previous history of cardiac failure or cardiac arrhythmias, because pimavanserin can further worsen the condition by increasing the QT interval. If you have the physiological conditions like hypokalemia and hypomagnesemia can also increase the risk when they are combined with pimavanserin. Another important precaution is in the people who are having the psychosis. Particularly in the elders who are having the psychosis, they may also have dementia. And dementia sometimes can lead to psychosis, which is called dementia-induced psychosis. In such people, pimavanserin can control the psychotic symptoms, but it should be carefully given because this drug can increase the risk of cerebrovascular complications, which may lead to development of stroke, and even it can increase the risk of infections. So in the dementia-related psychosis, the safety of pimavanserin is not completely established. So in such people, use of pimavanserin is still not recommended. Now let us see the side effects of this medication. This medication mainly produces peripheral edema, resulting in the swelling of legs, and it can produce some confusion, nausea. It can also produce some constipation and fatigue, lack of energy. Finally, it can also produce some urinary tract infections. All these are the common side effects that can be observed with pimavanserin. Now let us see the chemical nature of this medication. So this is the structure of pimavanserin. Here the functional group is the urea. Let us give the numbering. This is 1, 2, 3. So we can write the suffix as urea. To this urea, at the first position, one of the chain is attached. So this is nothing but simple methyl group. So we can write this as 1-methyl. To this methyl, 4-fluorophenyl is attached, so we can write this as 4-fluorophenyl. Similarly, at the first position, piperidine ring is attached. And let us give the numbering to this piperidine ring. This is 1 and this is 4. So it is attached by 4th position. Therefore, we can write this as 1-piperidine-4-aryl. Now, to this piperidine, at the first position, methyl group is present. So 1-methyl. Now, let us see the side chain present at the third position. At the third position, simple methyl group is attached. So 3-methyl. To this methyl, phenyl ring is attached. So phenyl. And to this phenyl at the fourth position, an alkoxy group is attached. Let us give the numbering. This is 1, 2, and 3. So this is nothing but 4-2-methylpropoxy. That is the name of pimavanserin. So pimavanserin is a urea derivative. How it is given? This drug is available as a tablet at a strength of 17 mg. Initially, it is given as a 2 tablets once daily. So the total dose is the 34 mg given once daily. But in those people who are using CYP3A4 inhibitors like ketoconazole, itraconazole, the dose of this medication should be reduced to 17 mg given once daily. So in presence of CYP3A4 inhibitors, the dose should be reduced in order to avoid toxic effects of this medication. And pimavanserin can be given either with food or without food, but it should be given once daily as 2 tablets. So that's all about this medication, pimavanserin, which is one of the new medication that is indicated for the treatment of psychotic symptoms in the people with Parkinson's disease. This drug is selectively acting on serotonin receptors as an antagonist as well as inverse agonist, but it is not acting on the dopamine D2 receptors, so it is free of Parkinson-like side effects. But this drug should be carefully given in the people with any cardiac complications because this drug can increase the QT interval within the ECG. This drug is available as a tablet at a strength of 17 mg. The dose is 34 mg given once daily. But in the people who are using CYP3A4 inhibitors, the dose is given as a single tablet, 17 mg per day. So that's all about this medication, pimavanserin. Hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.